Do you want to know how to create loops in MATLAB? Then watch this video. A loop is a command or series of commands that is executed several times. MATLAB has two kinds of loops, the for loop and while loop. If you in advance know how many times you want the commands to be executed, use the for loop. But if you don't know how many times the commands are going to be executed, and just know the criteria that is going to terminate the loop, use while loop. The general for loop form is for var equals to f colon s colon t, several commands, and. This line means we have a variable named var, which the first time equals to f. Next loop f plus s, then f plus 2 times s, until it reaches or exceeds t. I type for k equals to 1 colon 3 colon 10, x equals to k to the power of 2. And. So at first k equals to 1 and x equals to 1 to the power of 2. Then k equals to 1 plus 3, which is 4. Then x equals to 16. Then k equals to 4 plus 3, 7. Then x equals to 49. And k equals to 10 and x equals to 100. Now we look at the while loop. This is the general form. While, conditional expression, several commands, and. So I type counter equals to 0. While counter is smaller than 7, fprintf, this is a while loop, backslash n. Counter equals to counter plus 2, and. Let's interpret the output. First, counter equals to 0. Since it is smaller than 7, we go into the loop, and print, this is a while loop. Then counter increases by 2. And since it is still smaller than 7, the loop is executed. This procedure continues until counter reaches 8, which exceeds 7. And we drop out of the loop. If I forget to add this line, then my variable that is counter will forever be equal to 0, and forever will be less than 7, so the loop is going to repeat forever. If this case happened to you, you have to stop the loop manually by pressing Ctrl C. You may need to use multiple loops within each other, also known as nested loops. For example, I want to write a code that prints this result. First of all, I know that I am going to print 3 lines, so I type for I equals to 1 colon 3 display star end. But this is not going to produce what I wanted. In the first line, I equals to 1, in the second line, I equals to 2, and in the third line, I equals to 3. So I guess the number of times that the star is going to be displayed in each line is equal to I. Now I add this nested loop. For j equals to 1 colon I, display a star, end. But this is not going well, since the this function always prints the result in a new line, so I use fprintf instead. It is better. Every time the nested loop ends, we just need to go to a new line, so I add a new line after the nested loop. Break and continue. The break command terminates the execution of the loop. For example, for I equals to 1 colon 10, if I equals to 7, break, end. I, end. We expect the loop to be executed 10 times. However, when I reaches 7, the loop ends. Remember, if the break command is used in a nested loop, only the inside loop, also known as nested loop, is going to terminate. Now this time I replace the break command with the continue command. You see the change in result. This command does not end the loop, but it takes us to the beginning of the loop. So when I equals to 7, this line is not executed, and we go to the beginning with I equals to 8. One last note. When numbers are entered by the user, it is often necessary to store them in a vector. There are two basic methods that could be used to accomplish this. One method is to start with an empty vector and extend the vector by adding each number to it as the numbers are entered by the user. Extending a vector, however, is very inefficient. What happens is that every time a vector is extended, a new chunk of memory must be found that is large enough for the new vector, and all of the values must be copied from the original location in memory to the new one. This can take a long time to execute. A better method is to preallocate the vector to the correct size and then change the value of each element to be the numbers that the user enters. This method involves referring to each index in the result vector and placing each number into the next element in the result vector. This method is far superior if it is known ahead of time how many elements the vector will have. One common method is to use the zeros function to preallocate the vector to the correct length.